Alfan, this is the sub mandibular salivary gland. This is also very important in the practical exam. And also Alfan, this is the anterior belly of digastric muscle. It is also attached in the practical exam. And this is the posterior belly of digastric muscle. This is a common facial vein on its way to the internal jugular vein. So this is the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. This is the intermediate tendon. And this is the posterior belly of the digastric muscle with the stylohyoid muscle above it. This is the stylohyoid muscle. And this is the intermediate tendon and posterior belly of the digastric muscle. Characteristic, there is a nerve here. This is the hypoglossal nerve, which is commonly attached in the practical exam. And you should not be confused with the hypoglossal nerve, which is this, which passes superficial to the hyoglossus muscle. This is the hyoglossus muscle. So don't be confused with hypoglossal with the intermediate tendon of the digastric muscle, because sometimes their sizes will be the same. Intermediate tendon, there is a muscle here attached to it. This is the stylohyoid muscle and the posterior belly. But this is the hypoglossal nerve. And this muscle is the hypoglossus muscle, because the hypoglossal nerve passing on it, but superficial to it. The myelohyoid muscle, it lies here. This is the anterior belly of the digastric muscle, and from the other side, anterior belly, and in between is the myelohyoid muscle. And this is the carotid sheath. This is a common carotid artery. And this is the external carotid artery in which branches arise. And this is the internal carotid artery. And this is the first branch of the external carotid artery, the superior thyroid artery.